the maiden edition of the business show. My name is Viola. Here is what's coming up on the show this week.
It is not important that you focus on building a very expensive website.
Let me tell you, when you be there in the office, you can't just think a lot.
For you to be able to bring in new finance, it should be in line on what you are going to improve on.
COVID-19 has forced most people to go online with the hope to reduce on rent and also capture clients that are unable to move due to COVID-19 restrictions. But are entrepreneurs in Uganda ready for this major shift? Here are the views from the top.
Gilbert Junior Regia, my name's, and I lead programs at Mercury Innovation and Incubation Center. And I'm also a programs lead and partnerships manager at Startup Uganda. With COVID-19 ravaging all around the world and here in Uganda, e-commerce has been the conversation that most entrepreneurs and innovators have been involved in. But the question everyone asks, do we understand what e-commerce is? So e-commerce, basically, for those who may not understand it, is the buying and selling of goods online while leveraging digital platforms and technologies that are all over the world. And this involves, most importantly, the internet and the other digital platforms that have come along, including mobile money and speak but a few. And what is very important for us to look at currently is how can we understand the basics of ensuring that e-commerce is successful here in Uganda without copying and pasting strategies and mechanisms that are all over the world. So the basics that we may look at for us to be successful in e-commerce could include, one, focusing on branding, ensuring that even before you think about starting up an e-commerce business, your branding is perfect or it is to the point. Two, it is important that you focus on building your own community. I mean, there are so many target communities that business look out for. Even the normal traditional commerce that we do, you must have your target community and you focus on ensuring that you meet their requirements. Important as well is to ensure that you understand the platforms that your target market is interested in. Is it social media? Is it Facebook? Is it Twitter? Is it using the website? It is not important that you focus on building a very expensive website when your clients, your target audience, does not actually like going to the websites. Of late, there is a lot of building applications. Apps have become apps. I mean, that's why, because almost every time all of us are on phones, which has made the building and the development of applications popular. So if you're to go into e-commerce, it is important that you identify what are the key challenges that people are looking out for. Is it saving time? So meaning that you leverage on ensuring that the value chain of movement of your products or your services is really, really fast to ensure that your customers or clients benefit from your e-commerce business. Talking about readiness of Uganda for e-commerce, I would say yes and I would say no. It's something that we've been engaged in our different conversations that we have as innovation and entrepreneurship support organizations in Uganda. To some extent, yes. There are a number of companies and organizations that have put together a number of strategies to ensure that e-commerce is successful. But at the same time, there are quite a number of other challenges that make e-commerce really hard to implement here in Uganda. One, when I say that e-commerce is probably, we are ready for e-commerce, is the audience has now a good understanding of what e-commerce is. So they know that doing e-commerce is saving their time, saving a bit of their money, having multiple options of the products or services they're looking out for, which to me, I think we as customers or clients of these businesses, we are ready for e-commerce. Also, the innovators and entrepreneurs, businessmen and ladies, I feel they are ready for e-commerce because they have learned from the challenges and the mistakes in traditional commerce, and now they are focusing on how they can improve on that. But what I think is failing e-commerce, and why you'd say that maybe we're not ready for e-commerce, is the infrastructure bit. Internet prices, of course. Internet is not everywhere. you know how it is really, really very slow for most of us who are using different internet packages, which makes it a bit a challenge for most of us when it comes to building businesses that are e-commerce led. And of course, when you talk about issues to do with what can customers ensure, or what can they do to ensure that they receive their products and services online, it is important that first of all you identify the right business that you're buying these products or services from. Eventually, it's not always advisable that because you've seen an advert or an ad online, you rush to it. There are quite multiple businesses doing almost the same thing, and you need first identify which company, which organization, which business really speaks to the challenges we have. So this will help you, for instance, if you're looking for a product that is around town, then you'll easily get your product easily if you're ordering and you're around town. But most times, because you have gone on Google, you have just typed the product that you want, the first website that comes is what you order from. It becomes a challenge. So there's need for us to understand how e-commerce works. The value chain around e-commerce is quite different from the value chain that we have together with supply chain that we have for the traditional commerce. So first of all, having information of who you want to buy from, where you want to buy from, and why you need to buy from such an e-commerce business, it is important for us as clients or as customers to know, I mean, for us to receive the goods and services we want the way they are. And this also comes, of course, with trustworthiness. I mean, which companies have done this kind of business before, and you trust them, and you know they can always deliver on time and deliver exactly what you ordered for. It basically beats an understanding where people say, I ordered for this bag, I got a different bag. All because most times you have not identified credible companies that are doing this kind of business. And of course, as we try to emphasize innovation and entrepreneurship growth, we are also ensuring that these startup companies also learn from the companies that have done this before, and they can actually do best practices in e-commerce. It is important for all stakeholders in e-commerce to understand what it takes for e-commerce to be sustainable. And one of the things that businesses must understand, those that are in e-commerce, is that there's already available infrastructure that they need to utilize. For instance, the transportation sector here in Uganda has been one of those sectors that has helped e-commerce to grow. So sustainability of e-commerce wholly depends on partnerships and collaboration. So you're doing e-commerce, but you must be in contact, or you must be in collaboration with transportation key stakeholders. You've seen what partners like Safe Border are doing, what Jumia is doing around leveraging on already the transportation sector. Apart from that, you realize that putting up your own infrastructure is quite expensive. So that's why it is important, as an e-commerce player, you identify the stakeholders who may help you reach your last mile distribution. So first of all, putting up a website, a real e-commerce website, is not cheap, right? But we already have the available infrastructure, like we've seen Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp itself. Those are just some of the infrastructure that is already available, that if one leveraged on, if one really put in a lot of effort to ensure that you understand this kind of infrastructure, you can actually do very well when it comes to e-commerce. It is also very important for us to understand that much as e-commerce has reduced the interaction between the buyer and the seller, and has made it so seamless that they are no longer what we call the go-between kind of people. But you also see that it is important for us to keep in touch with our clients, with our customers. And already the available infrastructure I'm talking about has some of these features or modules that can enable the interaction to go on, right? So you've ordered for something, it is delivered, and you can only just receive it from your gate or from your reception, and you have no sort of contact with whoever sold you this particular product. It is important for us, those who are planning, or those already into e-commerce, to understand that it is important to receive feedback from your clients. So if there is nothing like a feature where you're supposed to get a rating, I mean, some of you must have seen ratings that e-commerce businesses do. You need to rate a service that has been offered to you. This is one way of me, the person who is selling to you this product, to understand if the service I'm providing or the product I'm providing has really satisfied your needs. So businesses must understand that there must be customer relationship management, something that we have struggled to do in the traditional commerce, to ensure that apart from me buying your product, what else? What is the after-sale services? Is there something else that you're offering in terms of information? For instance, there are new products or services that have come. How will I know if I just bought a product and that was it? I mean, there's nothing like a follow-up to understand how the product or service was beneficial to me. So clients need to keep in touch with the businesses or with those companies they buy from. But very important for the businesses or the companies, they need to get this information. So information has actually been a problem when it comes to business. You don't understand what your clients like. You don't understand what they like most and what they don't like. Why? Because you probably think that after selling, that's the end of the e-commerce process. But it should be, this process should end when you have received feedback from these clients and when they are either satisfied or not satisfied with reasons that you can actually work on to improve your business.
Well, you've heard what you need to consider the next time you transact online or plan to start an online business. You are still watching The Business Show. There is so much more lined up for you. But first, we'll take a break.